And then the second one was right here. And I have, I love these band-aids. They're Nexcare, N-E-X-C-A-R-E. I love them. They're waterproof band-aids. They are awesome. You know, most band-aids, when they get wet, they, you know, they come off. These, I mean, eventually they will come off, but these are different. And they're very, very flexible too. So you can put them in a place where they're going to stretch and bend, and it's totally okay. This is one of the smaller ones. This place happened Sunday. I think it was the Sunday. It might have actually been Saturday. So maybe it was longer ago. Okay. No, it was Sunday. I was outside and I had my little leaf. I have a leaf blower, but it also has a vacuum feature on it. And I was out there vacuuming up leaves, and my son was out there helping me. He was picking up sticks, and my neighbor has a magnolia tree, so those big, look like hand grenades fall in my yard off the magnolia tree. I had him going around and picking all that stuff up while I was vacuuming. I got over near the fence, and there was a bunch of leaves right up next to the fence. Like, there's a board here, and there were a bunch of leaves in there, so I was kind of doing the little thing down in there to get the leaves out, and somehow I managed to scrape my knuckle on the fence. Just like, I just went straight down and it scraped my knuckle really bad right here. So that's why I have that. And then I had one more injury. I was in a weight training class tonight, and we use a bar with plates, you know, and free weights and stuff. And we were transitioning from, we were using free weights, and then we had to quickly change back to the bar. And I had a free weight in my hand, and I went to put it down really quickly, and the edge of the bar was right there, and my finger hit the edge of the bar, and I hurt my finger. It really hurt too. You know, anytime you hurt your pinky, it's like, it's so painful for some reason. But I've wrapped a little band-aid around it. This is another one of those Nexcare bandages, and you know, I can go take a shower and this, it won't come off. I mean, unless I pull it off, it really stays on even when it's wet. So yeah, that's my three injuries. Okay, and if you watch my other channel or follow me on Facebook, you might be aware of my experience with my door. I am collecting videos and everything, and I've been keeping notes of getting my front door replaced. If you thought the threshold saga was bad, this is worse. This has turned into an absolute nightmare situation. It is so bad that I don't know. It's not over. It's not over. So that has been a big disappointment for me. I thought that I could just get, you know, get my storm door, my front door, just completely get everything replaced. The door frame, everything. Just get it all redone. Because I wasn't happy with it. No, it has not gone well at all. And it's still ongoing. It has not resolved itself yet. So that has been a big, disappointment lately. Window World of the Triad is the name of the company. Window World of the Triad is a dumpster fire. Don't work with them. I'm going to do a video on here, like I did with the threshold and the kitchen counters and the whole saga of getting my door replaced. I don't know yet how it's going to end. I know there's going to be a report to the Better Business Bureau, among other things, but so far it's not going well with the Window World of the Triad. They are not being nice to me. Basically, it's, they made some mistakes, some pretty serious mistakes with the door and the measurements of everything, which caused a huge delay. And basically what they've told me is tough luck. They don't care. They really don't care. So far, they just don't. It's like, yeah, too bad. Window World of the Triad. Yes, they have screwed me over, and I will be talking about Window World of the Triad in the future in a separate video. So that has been the biggest disappointment lately, is Window World of the Triad right here in Greensboro, North It's really cute. I really like it. And the back just has this pattern on it. And then down the sleeve, it has a cool pattern. But this is not a sweater. This is some sort of, like a, I don't know what this is, like a polyester knit, a polyester weave of some sort. This is like a thermal underwear material. This is not a sweater. I would not call this a sweater. It was supposed to be like a knitted sweater. That's not what this is at all. I am remarkably disappointed in the material. It's extremely thin. It's that stuff that always feels cold next to your skin. No matter what you do, it just feels, it feels very cold to the touch, which is the last thing I want in the middle of winter. But I mean, I do like the pattern. It is cool. And it's also way bigger than it was supposed to be. I measured it and, you know, I ordered a small. This is not a small. But we don't know because there's literally no tag in this thing. So, how do they know what size they're sending? There's no size tag in here anywhere. And for what these things, what they cost with the shipping and everything, they really should have been better quality. So it's really big. It's not really a sweater. I don't know. I'll probably keep it because it's Volkswagen buses. It's a tree of Volkswagen buses. I mean, I could always wear like a turtleneck or something under it, I guess. It is kind of cute. But yeah, I obviously didn't get to wear it for Christmas. This past Christmas. Oh, what does it say down here? It says, cruising towards a Merry Christmas. Only it cruised right past Christmas and arrived in January. And I got one more. And again, this is the same material. No size tag, no nothing. I should know better than to order stuff off the internet. I really should. But this one's cute. But the picture's a little weird. See, it looks like, okay, so it has a, this bus has a Christmas tree on top of it. But if you look at it, the tree is completely covering the window. Like, how is the driver gonna be able to see out? My son pointed this out. He said, Mom, why is that tree sitting up there like that? I said, well, they're probably taking it off to decorate it for Christmas. He said, how can they see out? I said, I don't know. I have no idea. Maybe they'll have to get the passenger to do it. I don't know. So, and then the back looks like this. And it's decorated with like, it's decorated crisscross pistons, which I thought was kind of clever, and you have little ornaments and stockings and everything. So I mean, you know, I mean, again, it's cold. It's just like, it just feels cold. It's like it's not really even like polyester. It's like nylon. It's like some kind of weird nylon fabric, and it's really thin. Love to see how he was gonna do it. If you ever got
like this. It's beautiful.
Just still never see big people in his picture.